Okay, so good evening class, and today is the last class and I will complete my allotted portion. So this class will be a very small class, I don't know, hardly 15 to 20 minutes, okay, or less than that. So we will talk about the last topic of the chapter, that is ethical dilemma. Okay, we know what is dilemma. Okay, when we are in a situation, when we are in a situation where we have to take decision. Okay, so an ethical dilemma is one in which a person has to choose between two options, and both the options are very undesirable and both are correct, but the person have to choose between these two options. Person have to choose any one of this option. So this is called an ethical dilemma, when we are get confused, when a person get confused, when a person have to choose between two things, and the person will get confused always, then only it will give rise to dilemma. Otherwise it is not a dilemma. If you could take a decision instantly, that's not dilemma. Dilemma arises when you get confused, when you are not able to understand what decision to be focused on and which decision to be taken. Suppose you're attending your examination. And you know that if you help your friend is way better than you. But at that moment of time, you are in a dilemma, because your friend is asking for help. And second dilemma is what? That if you help your friend might score more than you. So both the situations, see, it's so undesirable. Both the options are correct. You can choose anyone. But the situation is dilemma. This situation is called dilemma. But you are confused. Though both the things are correct, you are confused. That is called a dilemma. This is ethical dilemma. Suppose, for example, a bank manager is facing a dilemma when, suppose, his friend have asked for sanction of a loan, is requesting his good friend. Now it is the dilemma of the bank manager whether that he will support his friend or to think that there is a chance of default. He knows that his friend could not pay. It might so happen that his friend could not pay because a friend is unable to give anything in mortgage, suppose. So as a bank manager, suppose you're a bank manager and your friend arrives. Your friend comes to you and asks for sanctioning a loan, but your friend is not having enough property or enough security to mortgage. So as a bank manager, what you will do? You are in a dilemma, because what you will think, for whom you will think, about your good friend, about your friendship, or about the organization where you work for? You are a bank manager, tor kache tor friend eshe bollo je amar ei loan ta sanction kore de, amar khub dorkar. You তুই দেখতে পাচ্ছিস ফ্রেন্ডটার খুব দরকার, বাট ফ্রেন্ডের কাছে তুই জানিস যে এনাফ সিকিউরিটি নেই, সো দের সিচুয়েশন ক্যান রাইজ যে ফ্রেন্ডটা ডিফল্ট করে দিল, লোনটা পে ব্যাক করতে পারলো না। সো এই মোমেন্টে দাঁড়িয়ে তুই কি ডিসিশন নিবি তাহলে ডিলেমার কি ডিসিশন নিবি? কারেক্ট, বা ধর সাপোজ কর্পোরেট এক্সিকিউটিভ তোর যে ড্রাইভার, যে তোর কার ড্রাইভ করে, তার পাশের বাড়িতে একজন রিলেটিভ আছে যার ছেলে ইজ প্যারালাইজড। সো এবার এই রিলেটিভটা জাস্ট রিকোয়েস্ট করেছে তোর ড্রাইভারকে যে প্যারালাইজ ছেলেকে ওই স্পেশাল স্কুলস হয় সেখানে যেন ড্রপ করে দেয় এভরিডে, বিকজ সেটা ওই ড্রাইভারের কোনো খরচ হবে না, বিকজ ইটস ইয়োর কার, কর্পোরেট এক্সিকিউটিভের কার। সো নাও দিস ড্রাইভার ইজ অ্যাট এ ডিলেমা, যে কি ডিলেমা, whether ও ওর নিডি রিলেটিভকে সাপোর্ট করবে নাকি কোম্পানির যে কার্ডটা ইউজ হচ্ছে সেইটাকে বাঁচাবে, কোনটা করবে? সি বোথ দ্য সিচুয়েশনস আর কারেক্ট। ও যে বোথ এই যে ডিলেমাতে রয়েছে, ইটস এ কারেক্ট থিং। বোথ দ্য অপশনস আর কারেক্ট, বাট বোথ আর আনডিজায়ারেবল, মানে কোনটা করবে? দ্যাট ইজ ওয়াই ডিলেমা ইজ রাইজিং, রাইট? দ্য সিচুয়েশন ইজ ভেরি আনডিজায়ারেবল। ইউ হ্যাভ বোথ অপশন অ্যান্ড বোথ দ্য অপশনস আর কারেক্ট, হোয়াট এভার ইউ অপ্ট ফর ইজ কারেক্ট। But this tension, this situation, this confusion give rise to ethical dilemma, which we can also refer to as what? Ethical paradox. Ethical paradox, because this both alternatives available are just contradictory to each other. If I don't want to use the car of my office, then I cannot drop my needy relative. So both are contradictory to each other. So it is also known as what? Ethical paradox. It is also known as ethical paradox. The holder of the dilemma is known as the agent. Agent is a person who have to take the decision. Agent is the person who have to take the decision. Okay. And another party is the principal. Suppose you are working in a bank, then bank is the principal, and that bank manager who have to take a decision, or you are the bank manager and you have to take the decision, you are the agent. So the person who is taking the decision is called the agent, who tries to take the best possible decision on behalf of whom? The principal. So here the bank manager will try to take the best decision on behalf of whom? On the behalf of the principal, that is the bank where he is working. This is ethical dilemma. So holder of the dilemma is who? The holder of the dilemma is the agent who have to take the decision. So dilemma is providing what? It is the presence of a complex situation which will come suddenly, and the agent needs to decide the best possible way out. Okay, so there are two types of dilemma. One is personal dilemma. One is what? One is personal dilemma. Another one is what? Ethical, business ethical dilemma. So personal dilemma when arises? Personal dilemma, one is personal. So when this personal arises, when the same person is the agent as well as the principal. When the same person is the agent as well as the principal. For example, when a family member has to make a decision between saving the life of a mother or her unborn baby. Okay, when some family member or have to decide on what? Whether saving the life of a mother or her unborn baby. So in this case, the person, the member, the family member is not only the agent but also the principal. The only thing that he have to decide is to save the mother or the child. Correct? So here the agent and the principal is the same person. That is called personal dilemma. Okay? Then what is business ethical dilemma? When the agent and principal are two different persons. That is the example of the bank manager, where the bank manager is the agent and the bank and the organization is the principal. Correct? So whatever be your decision, whatever be the agent's decision, one or more ethical principles have to be compromised. Suppose in case of a personal dilemma, if the family member is deciding to save the mother, then it means that the child is being killed. So there is an ethical principle and that has been compromised. Suppose if the bank manager decides to give loan, then the ethical principle is being compromised. What ethical principle? That the chances of default, that the chances that the organization will face, suffer loss. So no matter whatever it is, in an ethical dilemma, ethical principle will get hampered. Ethical principle will have to be get, means ethical principle needs to be, we have to decide which ethical principle we need to compromise and which ethical principle we will follow. This is dilemma. A situation where you can take a quick judgment, quick decision, that's not a dilemma. Dilemma is this situation where there will be an ethical paradox. There will be two alternative choices and both the choices are contradictory to each other. Correct? So this is called a dilemma. This is called an ethical dilemma. Now, there are types, I have told upon the basis of level. This is on the basis of degree of conflict. Okay, so these types are not important because they are not in CU syllabus. Just remember the first type important. The first type is important, that is the basic, on the basis of the level, that is personal dilemma and business ethical dilemma. Okay, there is on the basis of degree of conflict, there is absolute pure ethical dilemma. There is also approximate ethical dilemma. Okay, so when pure dilemma is there, two or more ethical standards are applicable. Means more than two alternatives you have and you need to take a decision. Approximate ethical dilemma, the situation gets more complicated. It involves more conflict between what will be, between what value you will follow, between what law you have to maintain, what policy you need to keep in mind. Correct? On the basis of number of agents, there is simple and multiple dilemma. What is simple dilemma? When there is a single agent to make a choice and when there are two or more agents. Suppose the board of directors of the company. The board of directors of the company needs to decide whether to come out with a share issue or not. Now the board of the directors of the agents, it's not a single person. It's a group of person who constitute the board. Now, they have to think whether the share issue will bring profit or not. They are just finding that this share issue will be very much beneficial. Beneficial, but there is a chance, there is a high chance that after that the company might suffer any loss. So now, they have to decide whether they will come out or not with the share issue. So it's a multiple dilemma. On the basis of number of alternatives available, prohibitory choice of one alternative is allowed. In this case, what happened? You have only one choice. There might be two alternatives, but you have two choices. You have only one alternative to do. Just do it. And you don't think about anything. And obligatory, more than one alternatives are available. Okay. Suppose a person is coming to the bank manager, that person is unknown to that bank manager and that person is telling about loan. And the bank manager founds that that person is not able, is not capable of providing any security. So, he has only one alternative. What? Just to deny, the cancel the loan. Loan cannot be sanctioned. Okay. The boss will not think about anything else. So this is dilemma. When there is a situation where there are two alternatives, alternatives are contradictory to each other, and this is known as ethical paradox. And here there will be an agent who will take decision on behalf of the principal, and if the agent and the principal is the same person, it will be termed as personal dilemma. If they are two different person, it will be termed as business ethical dilemma. Correct? Okay. So, after reading all this, we come to a conclusion that ethical dilemma requires a decision. In case of ethical dilemma, there must be a situation. There must be ethical paradox. There must be an agent. Okay. There must be ethically conflicting principles, and no matter what, some ethical principles is to be compromised in an ethical dilemma. So we will never get a perfect solution in case of ethical dilemma. It's never ever possible to get a perfect solution in ethical dilemma. Is it correct? So this was the last portion, and today we have completed this chapter. Okay, I will provide you with the MCQs and nothing more left. Let's see whether we will continue this class or not. If not, then no more classes are left. End of this semester means with me, my classes ends at this semester. Okay, thank you class, and I will send you all the MCQs. Do not worry. Thank you.